So as some of you may know, I've been trying to go to the gym recently to slim down to fit in the Spider-Man costume. Between the Land Speeder build and the Mysterio build, I have neglected it a little bit. I have lost some, but it's definitely back on the wagon for me, seriously, because my Spider-Man costume is on its way with a muscle suit because I don't have the Spidey figure. But I wanted to make an accessory for it. So obviously my favourite Spider-Man is the Sam Raimi Spider-Man. It's the one that I grew up with, it's my favourite design of the suit. And I still play Spider-Man 2 game to this day and love it. The one thing about being Spider-Man though is your costume doesn't come with pockets. So if you're going to Comic-Con and you want to take like your wallet and your keys and your phone with you, either I'd have a spotter to hold your stuff, which I normally do, thanks mum. Or you just gotta try and bring a bag and stick it in the bag, but a bag itself it doesn't work. Some people have the bags that are like from the films, like from Tom Holland's Spider-Man one. Some people make web packs. I will be making one of those for my buddy Matt, who is also getting a new Spider-Man suit. But for my Spider-Man, I wanted something a little bit different. So we're kind of embracing what has become a meme, which is Spider-Man's other job as a pizza deliverer in Spider-Man 2. The missions that absolutely kill me in the Spider-Man 2 game, which I've been playing since 2004 and have yet to complete, because those missions are stupidly hard. I'm on something like mission 17 and I can't get past it. But taking inspiration from that, he has this big burgundy bag that goes on his back, which is the pizza bag. But to embrace that a little bit more, I thought I'd also make a pizza to go inside it. So if people wanted to pose with a pizza, they can. So the backpack in the game is just burgundy, it doesn't have logos on it, but I'm gonna take the logos from the film and like transpose it on the pizza box and on the backpack as well. But first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna work on the pizza because that's gonna be the really, really fun bit to do. So this is just a bog standard pizza box from totally not Pizza Hut, other pizza places are available. So this comes free with every order of pizza. Only thing we gotta do is we gotta cover up all the logos so we can do our own. So what I'm gonna do is just gonna quickly tape up some edges where I don't want paint to go and then spray it red. Don't have to do any prep, it's cardboard. This is great, this is gonna be well easy. Okay guys, so there's our lovely repainted pizza box, just using a picture I found online of the Joe's Pizza logo. Cut out most of the stencil, I just thought I'd draw that final bit on because it would have been really fiddly with the stencil. My handwriting is absolutely terrible, so that's as best as it's going to be for now, but it will do. So red, we got a logo, now we've actually got to fill it with a pizza. We got a couple of sections of EVA foam, we just need to cut it down so it will fit in the box. Okay, so this round bit is the base for our dough, as it were, and this one is gonna be our crust. So as you can see, they're a bit wonky because they're stored rolled up, so what I'm gonna do is grab the heat gun, flatten them out, and get the Dremel out and just start working on cutting this down. Well, just rounding out all this inside edge, so I can't do that once it's stuck on. So once I've done that, then I'll put it on here, then I'll round this outside edge off. And we can start work on doing all the little topping details.
we've got our base. Oh, we're done set together. I've just marked out the lines where the slices are going to be. Also, change of scenery because it's really, really hot in the workshop. So I've moved up here where it's cooler because we're currently having another heat wave. And I'm using some of this stuff, which is craft clay from Polyprops. I've used this once before for a little bit of detail work on Mysterio. So the description on the tub reads, ultra light clay which cures to a foam-like density and surface quality, 30 minute work time, 24 hours cure time, and yeah, so basically it's like a clay but made out of foam. The texture is quite hard to describe when it's just like this. It's kind of oily but doesn't leave like an oily residue on your hands like you would expect from something that feels oily. It's really, really lightweight. Here's an example of kind of what it's like when it's cured. It just, it's basically cures to EVO foam. I mean, you can see the inside of it there. It just looks like if you just rip some EVO foam in half. So it's super lightweight and you can mold it and sculpt it into pretty much any shape you want. Obviously it won't be perfect like if you're doing a clay cast because of it's foam, so it's gonna have like little air bubbles in it and it's gonna be a slightly uneven surface texture. But for what we're doing today, it's actually kind of what we want because I'm going to be putting some pepperoni on my pizza, so that's what this is going to be used for. I was toying about with maybe, you know, some mushrooms and some pineapple, but I have the feeling the internet at large will try and sacrifice me to the pizza gods for doing that, even though pineapple on pizza is good and amazing and Hawaiian is the best pizza, and also I really like mushrooms too. I'm passionate about pineapple on my pizza, guys, but for the sake of the internet, I'm not going to put it on this one. It's just going to be some good old pepperoni. Now all our pepperoni slices are dry. Actually going to texture the base of the pizza up before we move any further, and that's just going to involve like a bit of burning it just to try and make it so it's not just a flat piece of foam. So I'm going to try and be very careful with this. I don't want to go too far because otherwise it will just look like burnt foam, but we're gonna see what we can do. So I've got my heat gun, just going to go around the edges and just sort of go around this middle bit. And a couple of the slices are going to be cut out, but the rest I'm just going to score with my soldering iron. You can kind of see the difference is already made on the outside edge. This is why I always say be careful when you're heating up your foam and always try and heat it up evenly, because if you linger in one place too long, you'll start to burn your foam. But this is kind of what we want for this, so just got to do the same to the middle, and we'll quickly run over the underside as well. Now, quite unexpectedly, the sort of the glue that has been left over from when I actually stuck this on, when you're trying to burn it, it actually kind of gives a little nice effect. So what I might do is just to get a little bit more of that contact adhesive, just splodge bits on, wait for it to dry, then burn it up again, because that'll kind of make it look a little bit like cheese. Happy accidents, that's what we like to see on this channel.
So one delicious pizza finished up. It's a bit stale, I think, but it'll do for the prop. I just quickly painted in the base, just one colour, because I'm gonna glue this in here, so it doesn't need to be perfect. And then these two slices are just gonna be loose, because all you can do is just shove them in together, and they should hold in, because I mean it's gonna be closed most of the time anyway. And we can just take it out if people want photos with them, so. Right, now the next thing we need to move on to doing is the actual backpack for this to go in. So for the backpack, I've gone ahead and already cut out some sections of EVA foam. This stuff is 1 centimeter thick. So I've cut around the pizza box, just giving myself enough room that I know I can slide it in and make it a little bit wider on the base, because I do want to use this to keep some of my valuables in as well. So it's a double purpose. It's a prop and also it works as an actual bag. So obviously I've got my two main sides. I've got a top, I've got a bottom, and I got the two sides here. What we're gonna do now is use our trusty contact adhesive and start sticking them together. Okay, so here we've just got some burgundy fabric, because the backpack in the game is kind of like a burgundy color. So just going for a plain burgundy fabric. This stuff's fairly cheap stuff. It's nothing sort of special, it's just something I got at the local fabric store. So I'm just cutting out a section that's going to be big enough that I can pretty much wrap the whole outside of this thing in one go, and then probably cut up some bits that I can actually put on the inside of this as well. And I thought, actually, instead of doing foam straps, I do have some more leftover webbing, so I'm actually going to cover the webbing in the same fabric as well and feed it into the back and glue it in on the inside. Doesn't need to be adjustable, just big enough that I can still put my shoulders in it, especially with the suit, because when my Spider-Man suit arrives, it's going to have a muscle suit, so I'm going to be a little bit more bulked out, but should be nice and simple. Okay, so I wanted to put a logo on the back of this box. As you can see, I have done it. But unfortunately, this kind of material, excuse the phone, this material does not do well with spray paint. It does a little bit better with the acrylic ones rather than the solvents, but after a while, the stencil that I'd used spray adhesive on to get it to stick down, because it's only a temporary spray adhesive, it doesn't permanently stick, lift it up and all the paint has unfortunately bled. So I decided I'm going to do a quick fix for this, save having to redo the whole of the fabric. So thanks to my nan, who actually has some of this, which is a printable fabric. So you can kind of sort of see detail there. It's just a thin fabric, just comes on a sheet, it's got this backing on it, you stick it in your printer, print out whatever you want onto it, and then I think you can iron it onto a surface, but we're just going to glue it on, we're not going to try and iron this. And I've just gone for the official Joe's Pizza logo. They did have the website on the bottom, but I took it off just in case they didn't actually, you know, want me genuinely promoting their stuff. But hell, you know, the same logo is used in the film itself, so thought there'll be enough, and it's big enough that it covers our mistakes, because sometimes we have happy accidents, sometimes we just have accidents, and that's okay. So I put my name, Ace Cosplay, down at the bottom, just so you know, people might be wondering where to find me. So what I'm gonna do is cut this out, take off the backing, and just hot glue it very carefully in place. Now with the backing off, this is a little bit thinner because it's a white fabric. The original, what we've done here is showing up. So I might just need to just very carefully just paint around this, just so you can't see that it says, Joe's Pizza. So I should have some acrylic paint somewhere up here. And there you have it. A little bit of an issue at the end, but we fixed it. And I do quite like this logo on here. So that is one completed backpack. So we got the lining in there. There is a little pocket just down. Which side is it? Just down here. It's kind of, you can't see it with the light. There's a little pocket like you can put your phone and some money down there. So it's nice and safe. Got our own lovely Joe's Pizza box. Yes, I know it's red, not white, but red's my favourite colour, so I'm on a red pizza box. Our own custom prop pizza, and we are ready to go to Comic-Con. Well, I still need to get the suit first. Okay, so I'm off to go deliver pizzas in under a minute to people who are washing windows, because apparently that's what we do. So, I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Thanks as always has got to go out to my supporters on Patreon, especially to Jeff Kenny. Remember, if you like what you see here, please subscribe, and I'll have some cool stuff for you in future videos. There's a hint as to what's coming up in the future just down there. See you guys next time. Take care, and remember, with great power comes great responsibility. I gotta go deliver these pizzas.